Hi everyone, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today we're going to be talking about the Shapebuilder tool. There are a lot of different ways to use this, and we're going to go over all the ways that I know of, and we're also going to do a few little projects so you can see it in action. So let's get started. Okay, we're in Illustrator, and I've created a new document by hitting Command N or Control N on my keyboard, and then just opening any size. So first we're going to hit M to draw a few squares. And then I'm going to hit B, which is my brush tool. Come over here to my brushes palette and make sure I have one of these at the top selected. I'll just draw some shapes across here. Now the first thing we're going to do with the Shapebuilder tool is to merge. And when you merge something, you have to have them overlapping. Let's hit V and click on this one and pull it over top so it's overlapping. Then we'll select both of them. Hit Shift M, which is our Shapebuilder tool, and then just drag across the three. That combines them into one shape. I'm going to hit V to get back to my selection tool. Then I'm going to switch these by hitting Shift X. You can see this is one shape. If we hit Command Y, they actually are joined together. Now, this one is a stroke. Brushes are always strokes. Let's increase the stroke a little bit here. And now I want to show you what happens when you try to merge these shapes. I'll hit Shift M. We'll do the same. And you're going to get some weird results when you try this. Let's undo Command Z. So if you wanted to actually merge these, you would have to select this stroke and then come up here to Object, Expand Appearance. Now this is not a stroke anymore. It's a fill. So now we can merge it just like we did with these two shapes. If we wanted to do that, we could select both, hit Shift M, and then drag across all of these areas like this. All right, let's undo. The second thing I want to show you about the Shapebuilder tool is how to extract parts of it. So let's select both, and now just click once in here. And what that's done, it's taken the pieces and divided them. So each one of these pieces is separate now. Now hit A, we'll click off. Click on a piece and just drag it out of there. And all of these pieces have become separate now. Okay, I'm going to back up, Command Z. Now I'm going to show you how to subtract parts of shapes. So we can take our two shapes again, highlight them, then click Shift M to get to our Shapebuilder tool over here. Hold Option, we can click to remove some pieces that we don't want. If you let off Option, you can go ahead and just combine the extra pieces. All right, let's back up one more time. And this last thing I'm going to show you is just a way to create a shape from the negative shapes that your shapes are making, if that makes sense. All right, so let's hit L to draw a circle. So I'm going to draw, I'm going to hold Shift and draw a circle. With this part of Shapebuilder, you absolutely have to have things aligned. So go up to View and make sure Snap to Point is on. Now I'm going to go up here to my group selection tool. We'll click right on this anchor point and I'm going to shift in option and drag it over until it snaps right onto that other anchor point over there. Now I'll hit M and start right here from that anchor point until it snaps there too. I'll select all three of these with the V tool, which is the selection tool. And now you can see this shape in here. Now all we have to do is hit Shift M, click once in here, and it will create a shape. We can use our A tool and click and drag this out. So that can be a way of using it if you want to work with the negative shapes. All right, let's select all and delete. Now I'm going to show you how to make some laurels. I'm going to get a green color here, maybe a little slightly darker green. Hit L on my keyboard for the circle tool. And I'll hold Shift while dragging. I'm going to hit V, click and drag, and then hold Shift and Option. Then I'll select both, hit Shift M to get our Shapebuilder tool, and click once right in between there. And now I'll hit A, click on this, and pull it out. Now that I have the edge of our laurel, I don't need this anymore. I'm just going to delete it. I'll hit V, select this one, And then hit R to rotate this a little bit, maybe hold shift to get an exact 45 degree angle. All right, hit V, and then we'll pull this down like this, and then hit Command D. Now we can select all of these. You'll notice that the bounding box might be sideways like this. If that's the case, you can come up here to Object, Transform, Reset Bounding Box, so that it's straight up and down. And that does matter if you're rotating and flipping things. I'm gonna hit O on my keyboard for the reflect tool, and I'll option click right here. Now that sets an anchor point, and it also brings up the reflect dialog box. So we're gonna do a vertical reflect, and we'll preview that, and then we'll hit copy. And this is what we'll get. So let's move this over a little bit with shift and our arrows. Let's make these overlap a little bit, and I'm gonna select all of them. And now we'll hit shift M to get to our shape builder. And I'm gonna hold shift and just draw a box around everything. If we hit Command Y, you can see that it's combined everything in there. Hit Command Y again to get back to where you were. And now, while we're at it, let's just create a brush. I'll hit V, and I'm gonna drag this over here to the brushes palette. We'll make a pattern brush, say okay. Oh my gosh, let's cancel that. Let's rotate this around to the side. I'm holding shift to get it exactly on the 90 degree plane. All right, let's pull this into our brushes palette and we'll make a pattern brush. All right, it's looking pretty good. I'll say okay. Now we can hit B and draw with our new pattern brush. You would have to tweak it quite a bit to keep this kind of thing from happening, but you get the idea. It's kind of fun to make your own brushes. All right, so that is the Shapebuilder tool. All right, that's my video for this week. If you liked it, please click on the like button, and I'll see you next week for another graphic design tutorial. Thank you.